I'd like to call the Roseville City Council meeting to order for November 25th, 2014. May we please rise and pledge allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. Clerk, can we have the roll call, please?
Councilman Shoemaker?
Here.
Councilwoman McCartney?
Here.
Councilwoman Ha?
Here.
Councilwoman Hagerty?
Here.
Councilman Ayudo?
Here.
Mayor Pro Tem Taylor?
Here.
Mayor Cherkin?
Here.
Show all members present this evening, Mayor.
Thank you. Are there any items the council wishes to have removed from the consent agenda and placed on the consent agenda action item? Seeing none, can I have a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So moved.
Motion by Councilwoman Hagerty, supported by Councilwoman Ha. There any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is hearing of the public. Public comment on agenda items will only be heard at the first hearing. Upon approaching the podium, please state your name and address, address the chair. You're welcome to direct questions, input information, and or express opinions to council. Anyone using inappropriate language would be called out of order. Correct their language or leave the podium. Please limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anyone not adhering to these rules will be called out of order by the chair. Does anybody wish to be heard on agenda items only this evening? Anybody wish to be heard on agenda items? Seeing none, we will move into new business. New business, request adoption of resolution on abatement of public nuisance for the property located at 27759 Last Let. Mr. Tomlinson.
Thank you, Mayor. Before council is a nuisance abatement resolution for the property. This property is vacant, been red tagged since 2009, has a dilapidated house and garage and many other code violations. It continues to deteriorate as depicted in the photographs that were provided to you by the building department. We'd ask that the council adopt the resolution as presented.
Are there any questions for Mr. Tomlinson? Mayor Pro Tem.
Mr. Tomlinson, I understand that the property owner is out of country, is that correct?
That's correct. What we have found is there's been a number of individuals that have purchased properties internationally without even looking at these properties prior to doing so. Now, whom they're purchasing them from or how is another question, because many of them are red tagged. It's become somewhat of a difficult enforcement issue in the district court. So alternatively, we're looking at it, the civil remedy of nuisance abatement in this case.
And do we know if the taxes have been paid on this property?
I do not know if they have been paid or not with the information I have.
That's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Any other questions? Mr. Tomlinson, how, since the person is out of the country, what is our attempt process?
We've already attempted to send via FedEx to this individual the notice to appear this evening. We'll follow the same method so long as we have a valid address. If it comes back as no valid address, we will then eventually seek a order for alternative service from the circuit court, which typically results in mailing to the last known address that we have, which should be valid on the tax rolls. And if it's not, shame on the property owner, and as well as tacking on the building. And then a certain period of time passes for them to answer the complaint after the tacking, after the mailing, and we then move for a default judgment.
Okay. Any other questions? Seeing none, can I have a motion?
Mayor, I'll make the motion to approve the resolution as presented.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman McCartney to pass the resolution as proposed, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Request approval for installation of traffic control signal at the corner of Flora and 13 Mile. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor, council members, as part of the review process, apparently I'm disconnected, so hopefully you can hear me. As part of the review process for the redevelopment of the former Kmart site, Kroger Corporation submitted plans, and including the plans were some questions in regards to traffic, and a traffic study was conducted primarily to look at the traffic flow at Flora and 13 Mile. This was reviewed by our police department and then was forwarded over to our engineering firm and also by a separate traffic engineer. It has been the recommendation to approve a traffic control order for a traffic signal to be installed at the intersection of Flora and 13 Mile. This will be what we'll call an enhanced signal, so it'll be traffic pad coded, so it'll be affected by traffic flows. This is to facilitate traffic in and out of the project area. Again, it is a recommendation by the police department as well as the city engineers, and we have discussed this with the developer and the team. Would ask for council's consideration on approval to authorize the installation of the traffic control signal for the project. The cost for this will be covered by Kroger Corporation as well.
Councilwoman Hagerty.
Mr. Atkins, is this going to work in conjunction with the light at Little Mac and 13 Mile? Because they're going to get through a traffic light at Little Mac, and then they're going to come to another one?
Yes, it will have technology that'll integrate, so it will work with the flow of that traffic at 13 and Little Mac as well. So there'll be coordinated signals for that, so you won't have a compounded traffic issue or traffic backup.
Okay, thank you.
Mayor Pro Tem.
Mr. Atkins, is this a flashing yellow, or is this a full-fledged traffic control or device? I mean, are they putting in a, I know they, what they can put in with a, with the order, they can put in the red, you know, the green and the yellow, but is this just a flashing yellow for 13 Mile and then a red for Flora, or?
It will be a fully functional traffic light during the peak hours, and it does have the option to be controlled to a yellow or red, depending on the direction on off-peak times. So it has a smart control technology. But during the daytime and peak, it will be a regular functioning traffic light with padded signalization to allow for turns in and out. And then again, it will be synced with the light at the 13 Little Mac intersection as well. And then off-peak times, for instance, middle of the night times when traffic is a little bit less, then it would go, could go to a flashing pattern based on the traffic counts.
Okay, that's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Any other questions? Mr. Atkins, did Macomb County Road Commission have anything, since 13 Mile is a county road, did they have any input into this?
I don't believe they necessarily had any input, but they were contacted, my understanding, from our engineers, as well as perhaps the third-party traffic engineer. That's where all the information on signalization and traffic counts came from the county.
Okay. All right. Anything further? Can I have a motion, then?
Mr. Mayor, I'll make the motion to approve the installation of the traffic control signal as presented.
Support.
Motion by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor to approve the request as presented, supported by Councilwoman Hagerty. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request approval to enter into fiscal agency agreement between the City of Roseville and the Roseville Public Library. Mr. Atkins.
Mayor, actually, I'll take these matters as okay. I was involved in the drafting of these documents. I'm actually going to address all three, if I may. You have three different agreements before you this evening, the fiscal agency agreement, the building lease, as well as the employee leasing services agreement. As council's aware, some time ago, we had sought a separate millage by the library, and they became their own entity, essentially. So we have operated with an agreement with them over the past, gosh, it's been 2-3 years now. That hasn't been placed in writing as far as the lease of the building, how the services that we provide to them and at what price, as well as the employee leasing agreement for those employees that were holdover employees from when they were originally with the City of Roseville, now have been become employees or have been leased from us for purposes of operating in the library. Basically, what these documents do is memorialize those agreements in writing. We've reviewed them. The controller's office had been the one that had confirmed the dollar figures that have been placed upon them, in them, and they are prepared to be executed. I believe they've already been approved by the library board. It's been kind of an ongoing thing because when we had the transition with the controller's office, this kind of got pushed to the wayside inadvertently, basically. But The numbers are still what they are and what we'd agreed upon with the library board some time ago, and therefore we'd ask that the council adopt each of the agreements as presented.
Mr. Tomlinson, did they take up a formal action of the library board in agreeing to this also?
Yes. They actually brought in a council of their own to draft the originals, and we had some, I wouldn't say disagreements, but we had some discussions with regard to some of the provisions that were otherwise not what we had envisioned when we had originally done that, done the split off. But once we explained our purpose and basis of why our numbers were what they were, they came to the understanding that that was the route to go, and eventually we were in agreement as to how these agreements should be put in writing.
Okay. Any questions for Mr. Tomlinson regarding this matter? Seeing none, what are the wishes of the council?
Mayor, I'll make the motion to approve the request.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hall, supported by Councilman Ayuto, to approve the request as presented. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Mr. Mayor, would that include all three, or is that just...
We're going to do one at a time.
They should do one at a time. I just addressed them all together because they are kind of part and parcel of the same transaction or occurrence from the previous years.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request approval to enter into building lease agreement between the City of Roseville and the Roseville Public Library. Are there any other questions for Mr. Tomlinson? If not, a motion will be in order.
Mayor, I'll make the motion to approve the request for the building lease with the City of Roseville and the Roseville Public Library.
Support.
Motion by Councilwoman Hagerty to approve the request as presented, supported by Mayor Pro Tem Taylor. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is request approval to enter into enterprise lease services agreement between the City of Roseville and the Roseville Public Library. Any other questions for Mr. Tomlinson regarding this matter? Mr. Tomlinson, do they have control over their hours now under this agreement?
Yes, for the most part they do, but they abide by generally what we follow in the city.
Okay. Mayor Pro Tem.
The employees they have there are not technically city employees, or they are? Are they subcontracted employees?
They're basically, they're still under our rubric as employees, but they're utilized, and they're being leased by the library board. That's what the purpose of this agreement is.
Okay. That's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Okay. All right. Any other further questions? Can I get a motion then?
Mayor, I'll make the motion to approve the employee leasing services agreement between the City of Roseville and the Roseville Public Library.
Support.
Motion by Councilman Ayuto, supported by Councilwoman Haw. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item is appointments. I have none. Reports from administration departments. Mr. Steenland.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd just like to point out, I put magazines that were provided in the Now magazines. There's a really nice article in the magazine regarding the reinvention, if you will, of Macomb Mall. I just wanted to make sure you guys were all aware of that. And I'd also like to wish Alma Jamris a very special happy birthday. Her birthday happens to fall on Thanksgiving this year. I'm not going to tell you her age. I'll leave that up to her. But now that I did that, I got to wish my brother Mike a happy birthday because his birthday is the same day. So other than that, I'd just like to wish all the viewing public a happy Thanksgiving and wish everybody a wonderful day. That's all I have.
Thank you. Are there any questions for Mr. Steenland this evening? Seeing none, we'll move into reports of city manager. Mr. Atkins.
Yes, Mayor. Council members, let me first apologize for the electrical static and noises. I am okay over here, so I apologize that the microphones were switched. So if I scared anybody, I didn't mean to do that. A couple of items for you. Just a reminder that in observance of Thanksgiving, the offices here at the city will be closed on Friday. We will reopen on Monday, December 1st. Before you this evening, I placed a couple of items. You have a copy of the engineering report as provided and also the proposed budget calendar for 2015. It's that time again around the corner. We have a number of activities scheduled for next week. Most of you are aware of and will be attending the State of the County address, which will be on December 3rd. We have our annual 28th year Christmas tree lighting program, which will be next Thursday, December 4th, It will begin at 6:30 p.m. here at the municipal offices, and a lot of little added nuances this year. So if you haven't been able to come for the past couple of years or have never been, come for the first time or come back. And if you are a returning visitor every year, we think you'll be pleased with the festivities. And then on December 5th, the Roseville Public Library will present an all-day Mary Poppins extravaganza from 9 a.m. until the evening. They're going to have a number of activities, arts and crafts, clue hunt, magic show, movies, and they will be celebrating the 80th anniversary of the first Mary Poppins book and the 50th anniversary of the Disney movie. So all ages are welcome. No registration is necessary. Bring your umbrella and come on down. Also want to send out happy Thanksgiving, happy and safe Thanksgiving to all, and happy birthday as well to my favorite beautification gal, Alma Jamrose. So wish her a happy birthday. And last but certainly not least, I want to thank the council for your approval under the consent agenda of the agreement with Wade Shows. As we discussed in the previous meetings, we've searched very hard to get the best of the best midway provider for the Rose Fest, which we will be bringing live to you June 18th through the 21st here in the good old city of Roseville. And we are still getting a number of volunteers that are calling and stopping in, and we're looking very much forward to this project. And we again thank the council. Hopefully we've answered all of your questions and been able to assure you that this will be a great event. Mr. Tomlinson did review the agreement. We made some changes and tweaks, and those were incorporated. And we have this evening Joanna Hardesty from Wade Shows, as well as Michelle Glandon, partner in crime, co-chair, jack of all trades for the committee. So thank you for your consideration. And I want to throw a little last shout. December 10th, which is a Wednesday night, we're going to have our first all-volunteer committee. So anyone that is interested in coming on board and being a volunteer for the Rose Fest, we will meet here in council chambers on December 10th at 6 p.m. To do committee assignments and take those great ideas and shape it all into a wonderful form for a great new event with the return of some old-time favorites. So that is all I have. I'm glad to answer any questions that you may have. Thank you.
Thank you. Are there any questions for Mr. Atkins this evening? Any questions? Seeing none, we'll move into reports of city attorney. Mr. Thomason.
Mayor, I have nothing to report regarding the legal affairs of the city, but happy Thanksgiving to everyone.
Thank you. Are there any questions for Mr. Thomason this evening? Seeing none, we will move into the second hearing of the public. Second hearing of the public will be for any city business. Upon approaching the podium, please state your name and address. Address the chair. You're welcome to direct questions. Anyone using inappropriate language will be called out of order. Limit your remarks not to exceed 3 minutes. Anybody from the public wish to be heard this evening? Yes, sir.
Good evening, Council. Mike Clover, 29130 East Brittany Court, Roseville, Michigan. Two things. That Rose Fest, that does sound like a real good idea. I don't know who brought it up, but I think that'll kind of perk up the city quite a bit. And I don't know what's going to happen with the car crews. I guess that's going to be incorporated with the Rose Fest.
Yes, Mike.
I think that'd be a great idea. I'm looking forward to hearing more details about that. And second and last, as everybody knows, and just as a reminder for the viewing public out there, the Roseville Goodfellows will be having their annual paper sale this weekend. We do need paper sellers, and we do need donations. Whatever you can afford, whether it be a dime, nickel, quarter, 50 cents, dollar, $5, whatever you can afford, we would definitely appreciate it. And like I said, we do need paper sellers. I believe we had near 30 last year, I believe. Personally, myself, I'd like to see it at least between 35 and 40 this year, but we'll see what happens. For more information, if you do want to contact anybody about being a paper seller, and we would really appreciate it, the correct number is 344-2521, and not that 77 number somebody said a few weeks ago. So I just thought I'd mention that. That's Ed at 344-2521, or you can contact me at 774-4369, and I relay the information. So I do appreciate it, and I hope to see everybody out there selling papers or at least donating. And I would like to wish everybody a happy, safe, and blessed Thanksgiving Day. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Anybody else wish to be heard this evening by the City Council? Anybody else? Seeing none, we will move into items for discussion by City Council. Councilwoman Haugh.
Thank you, Mayor. I just want to also say with the Goodfellows, they'll be out on the streets on Friday and Saturday. If you can dig deep into your pockets and kind of play it forward, that would be great. It goes to a really good cause and for the kids to have a Christmas. I also want to say happy birthday to Alma, and happy Thanksgiving to all. And the tree lighting, please come out. It's a beautiful event put on by the Beautification Committee, and it's a great evening for the kids, for Santa, and a sing-along. So please join us.
Thank you. Councilman Ayodo.
Thank you, Mayor. The Rose Fest, Mike, is a living, breathing event that will continue to evolve until we actually get to that weekend, with what's going to be happening and how it's all going to be worked out and all the different events. The idea is a great idea, and it's just working out all the details. So, as they say, the devil's in the details. But it's all good. It's a positive thing. It's going to be a great thing for the city of Roseville. Tree lighting next Thursday, as Councilwoman Haugh said, please come on out. It's a great event. The Beautification Commission sponsors it. The Recreation Authority is helping organize it, as well as the city administration and employees of the city of Roseville. So it's going to be another great night. Santa Claus is coming, and I have been a good boy, no matter what you hear. So that is always an exciting day. Happy Thanksgiving to everybody. Take care of each other. Go Lions. Go Pilots. That's all I have, Mayor.
Thank you. Councilman Shoemaker.
Thank you, Mayor. This Friday morning and Saturday, I hope to be in front of McComa to turn around for the Goodfellows if it's open this year. I will be out there this year. I want to wish Alma a happy birthday and wish everybody a happy Thanksgiving. That's all I have.
Thank you. Councilwoman Hagerty.
Thank you, Mayor. Happy birthday, Alma. I think it's a special year for you, and you're doing such a great job with the Beautification Committee, so keep up the good work. The City Hall is starting to come to life with the holiday, and I know that the beautification ladies have been working hard. I'm excited about the Rose Fest. I think it's going to be a wonderful shot in the arm for Roseville, and I think we'll all do a really good job of bringing it forward. And I'd like to wish everyone a happy and healthy and safe Thanksgiving. And that's all I have, Mayor. Thanks.
Thank you. Councilwoman McCartney.
Thank you, Mayor. Happy birthday to Alma and Michael. How old's Michael? Jeez.
Did you say how old was Michael?
How old is Michael? I'm just thinking. You did say Michael, right?
You're younger than me.
Yeah? And I'm younger than you, so that's a good thing. And to everybody, a happy and healthy Thanksgiving. And that is all I have.
Thank you. Mayor Pro Tem Taylor.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. First of all, I'd like to start out by offering my condolences to the family of Mr. Lloyd Burns. Mr. Burns was a lifelong resident of Roseville. He passed away about a week and a half ago. Mr. Burns was 98 years old. Was a good friend of my family, and I had an opportunity to stop by the funeral home, and it was a bit amazing looking at some of the pictures he had. They had a picture there of his graduating class, 1937, from Burton High School. And he was on a 1935 Burton High School football team, which my dad and my uncle were both on. So it was pretty ironic. I had an opportunity to look at those photos. It was a bit amazing. So I'd like to offer my condolences to their family. He had a great life, and he was a great man for the city. Alma, congratulations on your birthday. I also like to wish our state representative, Harold Hall, a happy birthday, which was yesterday.
Oh.
I think his wife forgot to say that. That's okay, because I got it in for you. So, Harold, happy birthday. I know if you're out there watching, you'd appreciate that. Ms. Clandon, good luck with the committee. I think you're going to do a great job. you got your hands full. You're going to be putting the Rose Festival together, and you're not giving up on the Memorial Day Parade yet, no? Okay. So you got a lot of work going here. So thank you very much for everything you do and your committees and everybody else that volunteers in the city of Roseville. It's well received in the city of Roseville. Tonight on the consent agenda, we also approved the Roseville Lions Club to collect money in the streets of Roseville. And just so the folks know out there, it's going to be December 12th to the 14th. So if you see our Lions Club folks out there, please feel free to donate to them also. And Michael, he's got two numbers. He's got a home phone number, and he's got a cell phone number. So remember, if you can't get a hold of Mr. Ed Young with the Goodfellows, you can call him. I'll do it real slow if you got your pen and paper ready. His home phone number is 779-6776. And his cell phone number, if you want to call him, is 344-2521. And they're both 586 numbers. We're looking for volunteers. We're looking for a good turnout this year, folks. Like Michael said, we had 35 people last year. I'd like to see 50, Mike. I'd like to see 50, 55. I'm hoping to see some firemen, some Roseville police out there. I know you're going to see pretty much all of our council members out there that can make it. I know everybody has a busy schedule, but please feel free to give money to the needy families and children of Roseville. And on that, I would like to wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving. And that's all I have, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mayor Pro Tem. First of all, you heard Mr. Clover come up and talk about the Roseville Goodfellows. It's a worthwhile organization. Like Councilwoman Haas said, please deep dig in your pockets. Usually every year, the people of Roseville and surrounding communities do open up their wallets and give money to the Goodfellows, because it's no kitty without a Christmas. And I'd like to reiterate, I have a challenge for the police and the fire. The fire has wanted to last 2 years. I'm challenging the Roseville police to put some people on the street and see how much money they come up with versus the people in the fire department. Because I do believe the fire department at this time has got an edge. So I'm calling them out.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to offer a challenge to both of those two, that the council will collect more than they do.
Yeah. You know what, we probably would, so I'm not going there.
I will.
So anyways, but like I said, I hope that we get enough paper sellers, and there's more than there was last year, Mr. Clover. And I know Ed Young will be more than ecstatic for Mayor Pro Tem to give his home phone number again one more time.
I believe his wife's been handling most of the calls.
Anyways, I would like to happy birthday to Mike Steenlin, and I would like to say happy birthday to our state rep, Harold Haw. A few years ago, I was Googling Harold's name on his birthday, and I found out he's got something in common with a guy named Boris Karloff. So if you remember, he was Frankenstein. Harold shares a birthday with Frankenstein. My last thing is, you heard everybody talk about the Rose Fest today. I want everybody in this city to know one thing. Back in the old days, the Rose Fest was a great thing. I think Councilwoman Haggerty's husband, Leonard, had a lot to do with it. They used to have a parade down Gratiot. They used to have a Rose Queen, even that they had a beauty contest. Well, you know, the community spirit, you know, in these hard times from 2008, you know, we need to put that back into the community. And I'm really, really glad to see that there are people, our city manager and Michelle Glennon and the people from Wade Shows, that are doing this. I think it's a fabulous idea. I think it's fantastic. I had the city manager run some numbers, and you see the LA Fitness, you see the Kroger's, you see Macomb Mall, you see Walmart, National Coney Island. We've got an uptick in our building permits this year. So I think we're going to get a little bit more money in our budget this year, where we can come back and we can let the people of Roseville have 2 days of fun and entertainment with a car cruise, fireworks show, and a Wade show for carnival rides. I think it's a fantastic idea, and I'd like to commend everybody. And the fireworks committee, we're all in. Me and Mayor Pro Tem Taylor will be there again next year to help out. The community, we've been through asking banks and businesses to give money. Hopefully, we can do that a little bit better, since this year is a year that, you know, that we want to put in all our effort to get this done. And with that, I would like to say happy Thanksgiving to the residents of Roseville, and I'll have a motion to adjourn at this time.
So moved.
Support.
Motion by Mayor Pro Tem, supported by Councilwoman Hall. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. We are.